Hello and welcome to PowerBI Zone. Today we look at a very important topic, that is, what is the difference between a calculated column and a measure. So viewers, let's try to understand what is a calculated column first. Calculated column is just like any other column in your data, except it's not the direct pull from your DB. That is, you have to do the calculation in the PowerBI end, right? Remember one thing, if you come to PowerBI, so this is the data pane, right? So generally the calculated column is actually designed in the data pane, right? And measures are, you know, designed in the visual. So whenever you want to pull something in the visual, generally measures are preferred, okay? By the way, what is a measure? A measure is just a calculation that is working on the aggregate level. One of the most important difference is third number point, this one. So a measure is used in aggregation, and that too at the visualization level, okay? While a calculated column is used when you need to do the calculation row by row, right? And this is used in the data pane. I have just taken a very simple tabular data with country and sales, okay? Now intentionally, if you say if you see the data, you see Canada is repeating. Except Canada, all the other countries are only ones, but Canada is repeating. Let's try to use a calculated column first, okay? So we will go to new column, we'll click on this new column, and we will say sales. Using this is calculated column equals, told that let's go ahead and create a calculated column. So sales using calculated column. Sum of sales. What happens if we do a sum of sales and press enter? When you do a sum of sales in the calculated column level, what it's doing is it's going to sum up all your sales. When do we use a calculated column? What is the use of a calculated column? So if you come to this small example over here, we use a calculated column when we want to perform a row wise calculation, as so below. So first column is unit price, second column is quantity. Let's say you need to calculate the total sales using a calculated column. What you will do? 1.5 multiplied by 10, right? 115, 2.5 multiplied by 20, right? 50. So like this, you need to store the values row by row. At that time you will use a calculated column. Now let us go to the visualization pane. This was the data pane. Let us go to the visualization pane. If you pull the calculated column, look, and now if I pull the calculated column over here, let's see what happens. See, is this the value that I'm expecting through the sales? No, right? Because what is my sales for France? My sales for France is 300 and I'm getting 1459 over here. Look, 1459. What is happening? It is applying the same thing, whatever is there in the data pane. The only difference being for Canada, it has summed up 1459 and 1459. You see over here 1459, again for Canada 1459. So it is summing up 1459 plus 1459 and it's giving you 2918 for Canada. The rest sales is whatever you are getting in this particular column. And this is actually wrong. You do not want this, right? If you do a sum of sales, this is what you are getting. So you have to use calculated column very carefully whenever required. Now let us go to the visualization pane and try to solve it. How we can solve it is, as I told you, that whenever you are going to do your calculation in the report pane, always try to use a measure. That will solve the problem. Click on the top ribbon, new measure, and it will actually create the measure for me. So sales, this is using a measure. So to distinguish, I am putting the measure over here. We go to the next line using control enter. Now we simply do sum of sales. Now look, what if I do not use this sum of sales? I am writing sales, S-A-L-E, you see this. Automatically the type ahead is coming, right? And it's giving me two suggestions, right? What happens if I do not use the aggregate function? Let's say I only want to use this sales, right? You see, no column is coming. That means whenever you write a measure, you have to use an aggregate function. As soon as I write sum, you see what is sum expecting now? It is expecting a column. So now I can go ahead and select my table sales. Great. I'll press enter and I'll see what happens when I drag it to the visualization. To drag it, just click this, automatically it comes on. Now, is this correct? France 300, Germany 250. Let us go to the data pane. So, France, how much is France? 300. How much is Germany? 250. Correct. And for Canada, one cell is 100 and the other is 189. So, the sum is 289. So, that's what it's giving, 280. In this case, the correct thing to use for the sales of a country is not the calculated column. So, I'll remove the calculated column. I just did it to show you. This is the correct thing. You will always use a measure in your visualization pane. And if you're liking my videos, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel and like my videos, because it is through your like and subscription that I get the inspiration to make such videos. Bye, friends.